When Gennady sells out the Garden, sells out the Forum, I don't know how much more you have to let that fight
cook.
when it's clearly, I mean, Canelo and Gennady are two of the top pound-for-pound champions. They're two middleweight champions. You know, you could always kind of plan that, but if somebody gets injured, if somebody loses a fight, I mean, you know, look at Vladimir. You have one, he has championed for so long, he has one off night, and now he's, you know, trying to get the titles back. So, you know, Canelo lost to Floyd. So, you know, we'll have to see. I think, you know, we'll have to see how he does with Khan. And I think a lot of people are not underestimating Khan. I think Khan has great boxing skills. I think he's got great speed. I think virtual hunters are going to have a great game plan for him. I think Canelo is certainly a bigger puncher and a physically much bigger guy. But I think people are writing off Khan that he has no chance. And I think I give him a chance where it's going to be a competitive fight. And if he can go 12 rounds, I think he can, you know, he can pull the upset if he can score the points.
He can keep from getting a big hit.
Sure. I mean, that's hit, yeah. That's there's no question. I mean, Canelo physically, the way he took Kirkland apart, he's a big puncher. But you know, it's just a matter of if he can cut off the ring. That's where Gennady comes in. Where it doesn't matter what style he's one of the best fighters I've ever seen that cuts off the ring the way he does. And that's why he's always in a position to either deliver his punch or, you know, to slip a punch. And with, I mean, Bob, you hit it on the head. If it goes the distance, I think, you know, Khan could win the decision. But, you know, I wouldn't be surprised with Canelo's power and his size if he gets a knockout.
Tom, how easy is putting together a Daniel Jacobs fight?
What's that?
How easy or how challenging is it
for a Danny Jacobs fight? I think that's a great fight. Look,
is that a fight that can be made?
Danny made a huge statement by look. Anytime you can beat Peter Quillin in one round by knockout, that's a big statement. We were at the WBA convention in Panama. Danny Jacobs is the regular champion. Gennady's the super champion for the WBA. So that's a fight that would naturally make a lot of sense, especially in New York. I know Madison Square Garden has huge interest in that fight. If Gennady can sell out the Garden against David Lemieux, if he fights Danny Jacobs, who's a native of New York, I mean, that's a big fight. That I can see that being on pay-per-view, and I think that would be a fight that could be made if we couldn't make either Canelo or Billy Joe Saunders.
Speaking of Danny Jacobs, he's an Al Haymon fighter as well as Dominic Wade. How hard was it to get a deal done with an Al Haymon fighter on HBO tonight?
Well, I got to tell you that when Wade was named the mandatory, there was no hesitation from Tom Brown's standpoint. You know, we literally took about a week to work out the deals, work out the deal. And I know Al had signed off on that. And HBO recognizes, look, you know, it's a mandatory obligation. So I have a good relationship with Al. I've known him for a number of years. So there's, you know, my job as a promoter for Gennady is to get the best fights in the ring. This was a mandatory fight, so we had to do it. So it doesn't matter which promoter. I probably worked with 9 different promoters in his since he's fought here on the States. And it's just a matter of, doesn't matter who the promoter is, doesn't matter who the manager is. If we can make the fight with Danny Jacobs, that's a great fight.
And do you expect this to be the highest HBO regular Boxing After Dark number for Golovkin?
It's actually world championship boxing, and I think with the media attention, it should be as highest rated.
So Tom, what do you expect?
If the title fight ever does happen, Gennady's been running through everyone so easily that is it possible? Do you think it would be a competitive fight, the toughest fight of Gennady's career, or is it possible he makes it look easy like he's been doing?
Canelo is, when he fought Floyd, he was 22. Now he's 25. He's like in the prime of his career. He's got his man strength. You can see like the way he dominated Cotto, the way he beat Kirkland. You know, he's one of the top pound for pound fighters. You can never underestimate someone like Canelo. He's got tricky hand speed. And he's got good punching power, and he's a solid, you know, stocky guy. He's a real physically strong guy. So
Tom, you're going to be in Vegas next week.
Thanks, Tom.
Last question, guys.
What do you think will happen when you and Gennady walk through the arena? There'll be thousands and thousands of fans there.
I think he'll get a great reception every time he walks in. The first time he walked in the Forum, when Rafael Marquez fought here, you know, he was surrounded by people who wanted his autograph. So I think he'll get a great reception.
Thank you.
Thanks, guys.
Thanks, Tom. So there you have it, Tom Loeffler, K2 Promotions, facebook.com, and Melissa Beck reporting.